The CBS Radio Mystery Theater presents... Come in. Welcome. I'm E.G. Marshall. There are fevers for which medicine has no cure. The fevers that are self-inflicted. Drug abuse, alcohol, and perhaps the most totally engulfing of all, the rage to gamble. Gambling, the most insidious of all compulsions, because the weight of figures and odds cannot fail to provide a justification for the gambler, suggesting that he is unaffected by emotional stress, operating on sheer scientific principles.
Plus two. Plus one. Minus two. Even. Even. Plus three. Even.
Jerry, aren't we ever going to have some dinner?
In a minute, Ginny. When do you split nines?
What?
When the dealer shows no sevens, but anything from two to nine.
I think you're crazy.
Yes, I proved it. I can meet the house 50-50 and a shade better on my system. Now, what more do you want?
What we had, Jerry. Just what we had. No pie in the sky, no dreams of endless wealth, and not this sickness which has to lead to some kind of death.
Our mystery drama, Hit Me Again, was written especially for the Mystery Theater by Ian Martin and stars Paul Hecht. It is sponsored in part by Anheuser-Busch Incorporated, brewers of Budweiser, and Contact, the 12-hour cold capsule. I'll be back shortly with Act One. Outward view, no one could be more happily establishment than Jeremy Dyckman, a nice button-down bridge-playing commuter from Westchester, financial consultant in a brokerage firm, already tabbed to go all the way to the top, an expensive split-level ranch house in the suburbs, and a honey-colored wife, the epitome of the American dream, except that for one reason or another, there are no children yet. Till the evening this story begins.
Hi, darling. I have the martinis already.
Great. You don't know it, Virginia. You're going to need them more than me.
What are you looking so grouchy about?
Oh, hi, darling. Let's not push it, huh?
Far be it from me. Shall I pour?
Maybe you better hold up till I hit you with the news.
What news?
On second thought, let's have the drink first.
Don't you want to change your clothes?
Nope.
You usually do.
Tonight's different. I've already made my change.
Into what?
Into something rich and strange. A sea change, as Mr. Shakespeare had it. I'll take that drink you offered.
You certainly are a little weird, husband mine.
Huh? Here's to the future, when we might own the world. To us, to the stars, and to the time we can smile down on the Rockefellers and all the oil boys in Texas. You're not drinking, Ginny.
It's kind of spoiled for me since I don't know what we're drinking to.
Well, first off, to my freedom.
What do you mean, freedom?
I quit the firm today. I'm on my own.
Jerry.
Ah, you see, there it is. Criticism, fear, antagonism.
I didn't mean anything. It's just... Why would you quit?
Because I was drowning. I couldn't breathe. And most of all, because I finally saw if the object was just making money, well, there had to be a better way, a surer way, at least a more exciting way.
How?
Well, it would start with just one little pack of cards, like this.
You must be crazy. How could you, a mathematician, a computer expert, even think that in games of chance, there's...
But that's just the point. I am also an expert on games of chance. Now, Now that a friend has pointed the way.
What friend?
A man I know. You don't. That's unimportant. What is a principle that he taught me.
And the principle?
Card counting. Well, not just the simple matter of remembering what cards are in and out of the deck, but the mathematical odds on the hidden ones. With a little practice, I can now go to a town like Las Vegas and know that I'll win.
I don't think I can believe what I'm hearing. You should know that the odds are all with the house.
Of course. Of course, I could quote you chapter and verse. One-armed bandits, between 10 and 20%. Craps, dice, even averaging all the way. You still run behind the house by 1%. Keno, you buck a 25% edge. Mad. Roulette, play it in Europe. You still stand to lose, but at less than half what we do in this country. But blackjack, 21. That's something else again.
What are the odds there?
Never mind what they are in actuarial figures. The point is that the odds can be tipped.
In the better's favor?
There is no reason to do worse than 50-50. And if you really watch what you're doing and learn to play your luck, you can draw down from the house.
And you quit your job because that's what you expect to do?
Oh, I quit my job for so many reasons. I guess you'll be the only one to regret it.
Well, that isn't fair, Jerry. I'll be with you.
Oh, will you? Are you ready to give up the house or all your friends?
What do you mean?
Look, if I play cards, Jenny, I have to go where the play is. Vegas, the islands, Europe, Macau. I mean, it's a gypsy life, but it's not all that bad.
But what do we do with the house?
Well, sell it. Rent it. Who cares? We have no children, no ties.
You mean you'd just wander and gamble?
Yeah.
I know what's at the bottom of all this.
What?
I never gave you a child.
I never gave you one.
Is that why you're doing this?
I'm not doing it. It's already done. Now, where do we go from here?
Damn it, Jeremy. It just doesn't make any sense. I mean, it just doesn't program.
I'm sorry, KG. I can't really explain it myself, except... Well, it's a challenge.
You insist on resigning.
I want to take a whirl at this idea of mine.
It doesn't make sense, you know.
I'll never know until I prove it out.
How long is that going to take?
As long as it has to.
Now, what does that mean?
I just want to break out of a cage. Take a flyer at something I believe might work.
You have a contract with us, and I'm damned if I'll let you go. Too valuable a man to waste chasing a rainbow. I'll give you a leave of absence. No strings. Long as you want, within reason.
What would you say was within reason, KG?
Well, you're the nut. What would you say?
Nothing. No time is with reason. The whole point in a gamble is that there are no deals. Nothing held back. It's all right out on the table.
Not even a hedge bet on the side?
No, KG. Because no matter how I tried to forget it, if I knew I wasn't laying my neck on the line every time, somehow it would fudge up the whole deal. It's got to be all or nothing.
Okay, Jerry, you want it that way. Remember, you said it. If it doesn't prove out, don't you come crawling to me. You've had it.
It's all so senseless, Jerry.
I won't defend it.
But you're going through with it.
Yeah, something I gotta do.
But I don't.
Well, that's up to you.
If I walked out, you wouldn't even try to stop me?
I wouldn't have any right.
Darling, would you see Frank first? Just talk it over with him.
It wouldn't do any good.
What do you mean?
Well, I guess you could say a closet gambler.
What does that mean?
I've been gambling for years without you ever knowing. Horses, football games, the numbers, dice, cards. Maybe it's just a reaction to what I've always done for a living. Always dealing with about as close to predictable results as possible. What am I talking about? I sound like I really needed Frank, when actually he's the last person in the world I need. A psychiatrist.
Virginia, he's perfectly right.
Jerry is?
About not needing a psychiatrist.
Well, That's a terrible thing to say.
I'm trying to be honest. There are certain areas where, at least I feel, psychiatry doesn't work. Alcoholism, drugs, and gambling. In many ways, gambling is the worst compulsion of all because there is a kind of arguable rationale for it. You can get rich quick. And that's what our society seems to be all about.
Well, you're not much help, Frank.
I don't really know how to be, Virginia. First off, anyway, Jerry'd have to come to me by himself.
You know he'll never do that.
Yeah. So, that brings me to something else. He isn't my patient. But what about you?
Well, we're friends, for heaven's sakes. Do you think I need a psychiatrist?
It could have been the real reason you're here.
Oh, don't be silly.
I'll try not to be. You're walking the ragged edge. You're going to have to fall one side or the other. Either way, I think you'll need help.
What do you mean, either way?
We don't have to cut corners, Virginia. Either you go with him or you walk out on him. One way, the only thing I can offer you is something to stave off hypertension at the least. The other...
What about the other?
No. You are the girl I loved and lost.
You'd still be interested in damaged goods.
I only see the goods. The damage could be repaired if you break away.
Is that what you'd advise me to do?
You'll have to make that decision.
I guess I've already made it, Frank. Now that I've found out that Jerry has had a mistress for all these years, I'm not about to settle for second best. Let him get married to Dame Fortune, and I wish both him and the lady luck.
Six of hearts.
Hit me again. Four of clubs. Stay.
Cards, ma'am. Big king, that puts you over. What about you, sir?
Gentleman stands pat. Lady draws a nine, busted. Dealer shows 17 on my stand. Pay 18.
Pay me.
All right, Slammer, what is it?
We got another counter.
Yeah, sure.
I was dealing, but you can check it out with the pit boss and the cameras. He's a counter, all right.
How's he doing?
Treading water. He could get better.
So, a few wins is good PR. If he don't get too much better...
That's what we said about the last guy.
He was taken care of.
Well, what about the new talent?
We'll watch him. Figure what it's worth. If we have to turn it over, it's no skin off our noses. We don't have to fit him for the concrete boots and dump him in the lake. The troops handle that. So what else is new?
Nothing. The suckers still roll in.
Yeah, and since you brought it up, let's just keep remembering what puts us where we are. Anybody takes a real shot at throwing a monkey wrench in the works, ain't gonna be around to even have the chance.
Jeremy Dyckman has rejected his predictable world to enter a world of chance. And whatever his system, whatever his dreams, he already seems well on the way to being the classic gambler. A loser. His job, his wife, and even now his life seem to have been thrown away because of his compulsion. No, let's say a better word is obsession. And the first dictionary definition for that word is an act of the devil, impelling a person to action from without. I shall return shortly with Act Two. When I left you, we were concerned with the definition of obsession. But what of another definition for possession? It is an active and a passive state. Active in the sense that one takes over something or someone. Passive in that you are the one taken over. As, wouldn't you agree, Jeremy Dyckman has been?
Hello?
Hi. It's Jerry.
Jerry, where are you?
Same old stand. How are you, Jen?
Don't call me that.
Sorry.
Has too many overtones I don't like.
Okay. Virginia.
That has some overtones I don't care for either. I'll settle for Ginny.
Okay, Ginny. How are you?
I survive. What's more to the point? How are you?
The same.
You don't sound as if it's good.
It isn't.
Are you out of money?
Just about.
Oh.
But not out of hope and belief.
Oh. Why did you call?
Oh, just to touch base and...
That's good, because I...
And to ask you one thing.
What's that?
I don't know about lawyers, but our agreement is pretty well drawn up, isn't it?
Yes.
And part of it was we could split the joint account.
Yes.
Well, I don't mean to make it anything difficult, but could I draw on that $1,000 or $2,000 right now? I kind of need it.
It's all right with me, Jerry, but...
But what?
Don't throw it away. Jerry, please, don't throw everything away.
But why make it tough? Do I get it or not?
Wouldn't you rather have me?
No, for heaven's sake. How do I answer that?
It doesn't seem so difficult. It's just a yes or a no.
Ah, forget it. I'll raise the dough somewhere else.
Jerry? Jerry? Oh, no. Oh, Lord, why? Why?
Your fault. I deal you, sir. You stand pat. Yes, ma'am. Queen, you're busted. You, sir?
Hit me.
Yes, sir. Three of spades.
Hit me again.
Five of diamonds, eight showing. Stand.
You have a king up?
That's what shows.
Hit me again. Five of clubs. I show 21.
Nine in a hole. Pay 20 or over.
Pay me.
As you bet.
Hello, Jerry.
Ginny. What are you doing here?
What am I doing anywhere you're not?
Hey, you just brought me good luck. I cleaned up.
You mean it hasn't been going so well?
I just started to turn. No, don't leave. Don't leave. Just stick around.
Make your bets, please.
I'm not for blood this time. I'll let it all ride.
You make your own bets, mister. Everyone in?
Yep.
Cards. And a seven to the dealer. Second cards.
Ginny? Ginny.
Oh,
Ginny.
Jerry.
Come on, honey. Come on, let's get you under the covers into bed.
Oh, what time is it?
It's 4:30.
And I came up to the room just after 12. Didn't you miss me?
Sure, Ginny, only... Well, I figured you were tired. I wanted to get to bed.
I was tired. Tired of that silly game. Same old thing over and over again.
Not tonight, not tonight. Not the same thing one bit. Look, I think I've got it all put together.
All what put together?
The system, the counting, the way to beat the house. Look, read 'em and weep. 3,500 gilt-edged American dollars that I parlayed at the 21 table out of my last 300.
You won.
Oh, you better believe it, baby. From here on in, we've got it made.
Got what made?
Us, life, the big stake. Oh, darling, you don't know what luck you brought me and how I'm going to need you now.
How will you need me?
I have got the whole system now. It proves out. It works. It's infallible. I know it. Even if they switch to more than one deck, even as many as four, the constants are set. It's just adjustment. What I have to do is study, 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 and practice. Practice and study. And you can help.
How?
Look, here's a pack of cards. Brand new. Now, I'll shuffle. Clear off the table there, huh?
Jerry, there's something I want to say first.
Now, look, in a moment, honey, I just want to show you how it works. And no tricks, just me and my mind against the house. Clear the table. Okay. Now, deal.
Jerry, I don't know anything about blackjack.
You know how to handle cards. You play bridge, gin. Hey, take the cards. I will say four hands and the dealer. I'll be number one hand, three dummies, and you're the dealer.
Jerry... Please, listen to
me.
Deal
me a card. All right. Three more face down to the dummy players. And now yourself one face up. Fine. Now, deal all five of us another card face down. Now, the object is...
to get as near 21 in your card count without going over, because that's a bust.
But to score more than the dealer's count to win.
Oh, Jerry, honestly, I couldn't care less.
Now, listen,
about this.
Listen. Just let me show the beauty part here. Now, I've got a 10 and a 3, so I ask for a hit. Deal. 5 of diamonds. I stand on that, but that's plus one card in my system. Next guy, hit him. Deuce, hit him again. A 10, that busts him. But the 10 is a minus one card, so they cancel out. Hit the next guy. 6. He stands, but that's another plus one, though, because it's a 6. Now try the last one. Deuce, hit him again. 4, he stands, but that's 2 more pluses. That's plus 4.
But who wins?
In this case, you had to stand on 17 as the dealer, so I win. But that's not important. It's only one hand. What counts is, if the plus score stays high, I bet more units, higher wagers.
Why?
Because the longer the plus score stays high, the more chance there is to draw down a face card or a 10, because more and more of them are left in the deck. Now, the thing is to keep it all computed in the head. And that's why you can be so valuable.
Me?
You can deal for me, set me up in game conditions, allow me to concentrate on the count. Oh, honey, you don't know what a lifesaver you are turning up just at this moment. You are just what I need. We've got it made.
Oh, if only you knew we have.
Sure, sure. Tonight, I really proved it. I can play the house at the worst 50-50 on my system, and most times I can tip the odds my way. What more do you want?
What we had, Jerry. Just what we had. No pie in the sky, and not this sickness that's got you.
What's wrong?
I wanted to tell you something. Now doesn't seem the time.
Where are you going?
Away from you.
To another guy?
No. Maybe. Maybe there's one who wants me.
Frank Dexter, I'll bet.
Yes.
You could be better off. Maybe he can give you a child. I haven't figured a system on that one yet. Okay, go.
Oh, Jerry, you can't say that. You've got to give me a chance to change your mind.
No, I'm seeing this through to the bitter end.
And there isn't any point in my sticking around. You don't even want to listen. You'd never guess, would you, that I was sitting up in this plastic room praying that you would lose your shirt. Because I knew if you won, I'd lose. Goodbye, Jerry. I hope Lady Luck can give you more than I seem to be able to.
And you didn't tell him, Virginia?
No, Frank. I couldn't.
Why not? I mean, it's his right to know.
It wouldn't have made any difference to him. Nothing would. He's in love with another woman who possesses him, body and soul.
There's another woman as well?
No. Just the same old spellbinder, Lady Luck. Dame Fortune, the Queen of Spades, whatever you want to call her.
But if you had told him your news, perhaps that
might... Do you honestly think it might, Frank? You were the one who first diagnosed Jerry's sickness. Gambling fever, chronic, prognosis negative, no cure. Oh, and you were right.
I still say he has the right to know he's going to have a child.
Who says he is? I don't have to bring a child in the world to be hurt as his father could hurt him. That's another gamble I'm afraid I may not be able to take.
Plus two, minus one, minus two, even, even, plus three... Yeah, in a minute. When do you split nines?
When dealer shows no sevens, but anything from 2 to 9.
What? You understand. You see it now, Ginny.
Not Ginny.
Who are you?
The woman you really love.
I love Ginny.
Your little queen of hearts. Don't worry, Jerry. Look at her closely in the pack. So like, and yet so unlike. I'll make you forget her light beauty for my dark one.
Who are you?
Your Lady Luck. Just call me the Queen of Spades.
Yeah, what is it? Oh, yeah, that's right. I'm sorry. I did leave a call. I don't know. Thank you. Give me room service, will you?
Come.
Tally sheet, Ace.
Oh, yeah, put it down, Slammer. I'll check it out in a moment. Good night.
Could be worse. The count took us for a bundle.
How much?
About 12 grand.
Yeah, it's a nice run sum, huh? That's four times in the last week he stings us.
Yeah. Do we move in on him?
We might just have to.
Waste him?
I'm going to think about that, Slammer. I'm going to do a lot of thinking about that.
Jeremy Dyckman may have found a formula for winning at the tables, but it looks as though he's a loser all the rest of the way down the line. He's lost his wife, he's lost his child, and now two very hard men are in the process of considering whether or not he might lose his life. I'll return shortly with the last act in this drama. In a lonely house where she once lived with her husband and love, Virginia Dyckman wrestles with the problem of her bleak future. In a lonely hotel room, Jerry Dyckman tosses and turns through dreams of a surrogate wife who is fast becoming the symbol of the success of his system to win at blackjack. And in the casino office, two hard men consider dispassionately whether his system is to be tolerated or... even Jerry Dyckman himself.
Couple of questions, Slammer.
Shoot, boss.
You sure he's no mechanic?
Checked out every way. No razor blade pieces under the nails, no weather marking gimmick. No computers like the guy had last year under his raincoat, no switches. You saw the films.
Yeah, I studied them. I agree. Just a straight counter.
Them guys really get to me.
Well, why do you get so mad at him, Slammer? There are still plenty of suckers to even it out. An affair to have a winner within reason is good public relations.
Yeah, but a counter...
Everybody's a counter one way or another at blackjack. Some are just better than others.
Oh.
Maybe I'll have a little chat with him. Like maybe the next time he tries to draw to his credit.
Oh, evening, Frank.
Virginia, I've been a little concerned about you. I tried to call, but the phone was busy.
I've had it off the hook.
Oh, well, I was in the neighborhood. I drove by and saw the lights and...
Do you want to come in?
Yes.
Why not?
You're not looking well.
I don't feel very well.
Then for heaven's sake, Virginia...
It isn't physical. Just sheer brutal mental exhaustion. Oh, let's go in the living room.
Yes. Have you spoken to Jerry?
No. No, he doesn't need me anymore. If he ever did...
You haven't done anything else foolish?
Not yet. If you mean anything about my baby...
Jerry ought to be told, you know.
It wouldn't make any difference.
How do you know?
I know.
Well, what do you plan to do? I mean, I feel... Well, I think I have some right to ask.
Oh, dear Frank, of course you do. But I can only give you one answer.
What?
Pray. Pray that I'm not really going to lose Jerry forever to a rival... I don't even know how to fight.
about.
Ginny. Ginny, how can I make you understand?
It isn't Jenny. Jenny's gone. It's me now, Jerry. Me.
Who? Who's me?
Your lucky queen. The queen of spades.
No. No, I don't... I want Ginny.
Ginny's gone, Jerry. She's long gone. Time to wake up and start counting.
Oh, counting. Oh, I'm so tired. So tired. Oh, why go on with it?
Because you can't help yourself. It's the challenge. Nothing matters but the challenge.
What? I can earn money other ways.
It isn't the money. It's the dream. The pursuit. The battle that you love.
I love Ginny.
Not anymore, Jerry. Not anymore. It's me you love now. Me. Your lady of fortune. And you can't take your love from me because only I can show you the way. Only I.
No, no. Wait, I... Oh, the phone. Yeah? Who? No, I won't accept the call. Tell Dr. Dexter the patient is long since out of his hands. Be an angel and send me up some coffee, will you? I gotta clear my head before I get back to the casino. I'm doubling down.
Sorry, Mr. Dykeman, your bet is over the table limit.
Will the house extend the courtesy?
I'm told your bet is accepted. Do I hit you?
I'll stand pat.
Madam, one card, a queen, busted. One card to you, sir, five. Again, king puts you over on the table. Two to the next gentleman. Hit again, ten of diamonds. House wins. And the last gentleman stands pat. Dealer has a six showing, ten in the hole. Dealer must draw. Five of spades to the house. 21, pay no one. Sorry, Mr. Dykeman.
Yeah, well, you win one, you lose one. Well, that wipes the 5,000 in chips I started with. Would you ask the pit boss to credit me with another five?
He signals me we can't extend that credit.
I have 25,000 on deposit.
Well, I'm sure it can all be arranged if you don't mind just stepping over to the cashier's cage.
Okay, hold my seat, would you? I'll be right back.
Come in, Mr. Dykeman.
What's all this runaround, Mr....
Drew. Ace Drew. You want to make any jokes about it?
No jokes. None of this is very funny. I have 25,000 on deposit with you, and I ask for a 5,000 credit, and the dealer ducks it to the pit boss to the cashier's cage, and finally I end up here. Look, I want to know what's the runaround.
You play blackjack, Mr. Dykeman. What do you know about counting?
Well, I know an ace counts either 1 or 11.
What percentage of plus or minus cards are out of the deck? Or what the percentage on a stiff is? Or when the bet maximum when you read the deck is flush? Or a thousand other tricks?
What are you leading up to? Are you going to close your tables to me?
Our competitors already have. This here's the only game in town for you. No, I don't want to close it. You're too valuable to us.
Me? How?
Well, the more you hit, the more the rubes try to follow you. The only thing is, you're getting too much action. That's why I wanted to see you private.
A deal?
A deal. I leave you alone. You count all you want. I just want my cut.
How much?
I'll settle for 75%.
To you?
To me.
Who? Brother, am I in the lion's den?
And the lion takes his share.
Suppose I refuse?
You don't play anymore.
Yeah, there's still the Caribbean, Macau, the islands.
If you get there.
What does that mean?
You'll figure it out.
Why couldn't we have talked at the hotel?
Let's say I didn't want to share our conversation with anyone else.
You mean your room is bugged?
I mean my life is wired, programmed, computed, pick the term of your choice. I'm just an end result.
Nobody asked you to commit yourself.
Not even myself.
You could get out.
Maybe.
Isn't it worth trying?
You ever think I don't want to? Yeah, certainly you'd be the last one to want me to, right? Yeah, that's what you're up here for, to talk about me and Ginny.
The reason I came up here is to tell you what Virginia won't tell you herself.
What?
She's pregnant, Jerry.
I should go back to her.
Of course you should.
Only you know I won't. That's what you came up here to clear away, huh?
I'm not going to sort out my motives. I offer you a fact. You give up all this and come back to Virginia now, or...
Or what?
Or do you face a fact I've had to face, that I don't even think this is enough to bring you back?
Which really gives you some big lift.
Not really. I love Virginia. But she loves you. She just can't live with you as you are. No one could. And if she can't have you, I want her to settle for second best.
Yeah. Well, better have her settle. And I'm not downgrading you, Frank.
Even with a child?
Ah, what good am I to anyone or anything except to win a game in which the prize isn't worth fighting for? Only the compulsion that I cannot end a loser.
What's the matter, Jerry boy? You ready to be counted out?
Has to be a losing streak. Just a streak. The count still must be right. Right?
Don't be too sure. The cards, and even me, are fickle.
Oh, why do I have to win? Why can't I accept losing?
Because you're a gambler. You're caught. You're hooked.
I can't. Caught? Ginny. Ginny.
Forget her, Jerry. She's gone. She can't help you.
Ginny, what have I done to you?
Stay ahead, Mr. Dykeman.
I want to double down.
The house will accept the bet.
Yeah, look, get Ace over here, huh? He's right at the next table.
Mr. Drew.
Yeah, what is it?
Gentleman wants to talk to you.
Oh. What can I do for you, Mr. Dykeman?
I want you to raise the table limit. How high will you go?
How high do you want to push it?
You want to let me bet $5,000 a deal?
You got your limit.
Okay, dealer. $5,000 says I can beat your probable 20, draw to 18. Hit me. Blackjack. Pay me double.
Gentleman has a jack and an ace. House pays double.
Hit me. Deuce. Hit me. Five. Hit me. Big ace to give me 5 under at 21. Hit me. 10 of spades. 9 and deuce in the hole. Name of the game, 21. Go ahead. Beat me.
Dealer has a queen up. 6 in the hole. He draws 7 of clubs. House pays everyone.
Did you locate him?
Oh, he blew.
52,000 he took the house for tonight, and the big boss had to be here.
Didn't you tell him about the public relations and all?
Yeah, sometimes it can get too expensive.
So we fine him.
If he's smart, he'll duck out on his high.
Yeah, but if the big boss...
Well, let me handle him. Certain reasons I don't want him to look into this whole deal too careful. I can handle the roasting we took just so long as Mr. Jerry Dykeman never shows up again.
I can't believe it, Jerry. But I want to.
You can, my darling. My little mother-to-be. I can promise you I'll never gamble on cards again as long as I live.
Darling, I don't mean to doubt your promise, but how...
How can you be sure?
Yes.
Well, it won't be easy. But let me try to explain. Gambling Gambling is a macho thing. It's no use denying it. I bet my manhood against the house trying to make me just another nobody. I mean, they have the odds, and I've tried to beat them. And if I flogged my brain 24 hours a day, maybe I found a way to make them close to even. But then, suddenly, a miracle happened.
A miracle?
I can't explain it, and I don't intend to try to. But something happened which means I will never touch a card game again.
What is the miracle?
Well, it's all gone. The thrill, the combat. What makes machismo work? I don't know how or why, but... Ginny, before a dealer deals any card, I can see exactly what it is. I mean, it isn't a matter of winning or losing. I know. So it's like taking the alcohol out of whiskey, the kick out of heroin. What's the point without that? So I'm home. I'm home to stay. I only wish I knew what miracle made it possible.
Oh, darling.
Will you buy me, huh? What do you have to say?
Just something very simple. And don't ask me what it means. I get at least one free statement without question.
What?
Don't ever underestimate the power of prayer.
Jerry and Virginia moved to a small town on the East Coast and opened a community shop for local artisans and artists. It enjoys a comfortable success. And not the least of its values are Jerry's watercolors, which are fast becoming collector's items. So, with apologies, may I paraphrase an old aphorism? It's better to have lost and won than never to have lost at all. I'll be back shortly. Perhaps the most curious psychological factor in the gambler's makeup is that one would think that constant losses would eventually lead to a cure, teach him that he can't win. But the truth is that the gambler is the one man who expects and welcomes failure. The only thing he may not be able to withstand is success, and therein may lie his only cure, a pleasant one. Even if Jeremy Dyckman didn't choose to exercise his special powers, he ended up happier just letting life deal the cards and allowing them to fall as they may. Our cast included Paul Hecht, Patricia Elliott, Jackson Beck, and Ian Martin. The entire production was under the direction of Hyman Brown. And now, a preview of our next tale.
You meet. You hand over the junk, he flashes the badge, and you pull a gun, right? What's the matter? Now answer me.
He doesn't have to talk, Harry.
And you pull the trigger. You kill the cop. That's what happened, right?
Harry, you know the law better than anyone else around here. He doesn't have to say a word.
Oh, yes, he does. He does, and I'm going to make him sing the loudest song you ever heard.
Are you crazy? You can't rough this kid up.
He's going to talk, Jim.
Lay a finger on him, and you destroy the case. He'll get away with it. The judge will have to throw it out of court.
He's never going to get to court.
Harry, you're crazy.
No, Jim, he killed my son.
Put that gun back in the holster.
Don't try to make me, Jim.
You're a police officer.
I'm also a father. That is, I was a father.
You took an oath to uphold the law.
There's another law, an older law. An eye for an eye. Now, punk, you're going to die.
Harry!
Radio Mystery Theater was sponsored in part by Buick Motor Division. This is E.G. Marshall inviting you to return to our Mystery Theater for another adventure in the macabre. Until next time, pleasant dreams.